things are the major principles of the contribution of mind. So they don't accept mind at all. Now they are starting psychology, neuropsychiatry, psychometry, psychonomy, parapsychology, innumerable sciences they have started, even with technology of consciousness understanding. So they are gradually coming towards the Eastern thought or oriental wisdom. So physical. Second thing is this mental balance. There are three qualities of our practice in which it gives contentment, sacrifice and renunciation. Contented means it is a status, it is also, all of these things appear to be synonymous. But they have different levels of gravity. Contentment lies in the family life, and sacrifice lies in the common life, and renunciation lies in the total application of worldliness for a spiritual bliss. These things are just having degree variations. This type of sturdity gives you to withstand any number of hurdles and to contribute something for the welfare of the society and nation at large. These three things are the thick products as well as the brain products of our Eastern school of wisdom. Third thing is intellectual purpose. The purpose of intellectual wisdom or the intellectual training is not creating anything as per the gymnastics. As per the requirement, we have to create, not per the capability. For example, you can cut anybody's hand and you can annex a tadpole's hand. Now they are doing research about including the cells of pigs and rabbits for human development and tissue culture and their adaptability they are researching. You cannot just keep on doing things on the basis of your capability, on the basis of the real long-term solubility as well as the necessity you have to go through. So whatever their intellect is there, as it is misguided, as it is vidhava, as it is having no proper concept to manage it, that is becoming streamlined in a pathway of destruction, self-destruction, and also universal annihilation of all of the dependents and believers. So that is the greatness. And the spiritual thing is quite unknown to other people. So what it is India century? Number one, in physical salubrity, you are getting into problem, and India can teach you yoga, naturopathy, and Ayurveda to the world. Mental sturdity by means of tapa, dhyana, and various other sabhacharanas, that is the sublimits of that type, pranayama, pratyahara, you can qualify your mind and control that. Scientists invent everything through their brain. They don't know about the brain at all. They survive by their soul, but they don't know about the soul at all. They think by their mind and execute, but they don't know about the mind at all. Everything is being done by the fundamental force of the universe, the Paramatma, and they don't know about the availability and arrival of such a person at all. So, not available on the basis of the fundamentals, the rudimentary primordial factors of their survival, which necessitates and urges them into action and activation, they are incomplete and they are deserted, they are abandoned, and it is the duty of us, not in the way of a destroyer and a receiver, not in the way of a king and a subject, as East is always the big brother of the West. It is our compassion, it is our fraternity, it is our maternal care that we have to give hands to the West, and we have to enroll them into our honest, noble and transcendental embrace, in which their physique, mind, intellect and spirit is made comfortable. It is given solace, eternal solace, inexhaustible prosperity and real peace. That will be contribution of the big brother. Now with a brotherly bhava, brethren, we have to unite with the West. The West will realize and come soon. And you know that all greater journeys, they just begin with a small step, and today is a small step. And considering it as a small step, the available crowd, it appears to be colossal to me. It is more than a small step, and I believe that it will be fructified by the choices of blessings, the shower of the benedictions of the eternal reality who is instigating each and every person to unite. Already I told in the morning that it is a pre-sanctioned, pre-endorsed project of God, because it is a divine work. We are not taking our work. Even our work is done with the sanction of God. And if it is the work of divinity, certainly it is double sanctioned and God has given us a blank check. Let us proceed and succeed. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
I thank all the management and staff members of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Indian Heritage Academy, and Sri Ramananda Mission Trust, and all the other officers for their kind presence on this occasion. We owe special gratitude to the officials of the audiovisual staff, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan staff, volunteers, and officials who have worked hard to ensure that this occasion becomes
sit in a prayerful mood, invoking the Almighty Lord, known by various names, that this mission which you are starting today may take off, crawl, creep, walk, run, at whatever speed we deserve. After all, there's a karma. everything depends upon how much we discern. Adhikaratva, eligibility, qualification, effort, competence, character.
Karunya bhavena
raksha
raksha
maheshara
maheshara.
Our civilization has gone up because of our